Whoever is the host. Okay, cool.
So I'll start?
Yep.
Yeah, so first I'll go with physical activity. So to go there, we have to click on this exercise card over here. So I'm clicking on it right now. And then yeah, you can see a list of cardio, weight training, stretching, and balance training. So weight training, stretching, and balance training, it is just a checklist. User can just tick on it if they have done the task. So I'll just click.
Yeah, that's not also... that's not very apparent.
I know. Yeah. For me also, it's not very clear.
The UI was not developed. It was actually included because the after the meeting from the domain experts, we have just included. I told the UI guy to finish the screen.
Oh, sure.
He will update. Before the external demo, we can update the screen. We are
okay. Also, make it like the cardio very obvious and the other one smaller one. So
Yeah, sure. I told him that the cardio will be the main thing.
Exactly.
And, bottom of that, three checklists will be there.
Yeah, that is just show this as a checklist. And the major thing with this cardio, you just click on the cardio.
Yeah, that is what I have communicated with the UI guy. I hopefully will update the screen by tomorrow. So
you don't need to provide us cardio. You can just have a text box where they can enter the activity and just write it. Weight training, stretch, and balance training can be just as a optional checklist.
Okay.
I'll say just to show when they physical activity, just show that what they can. Log actually the data logging of the data, and that below the logging area you just show optional weight training, stretch, and balance.
I think I understood.
Yeah.
Lebby, can you click on that cardio? Yeah, I think below this thing you were saying, right?
No, you don't need to show this as a separate one. I'm saying cardio as a separate one because most of these activities will involve cardio.
Yeah.
Okay. So people get confused actually. Just show that the screen there itself. Under that, have you done your stretch training, balance, and this thing as an optional one?
Okay.
Got it? Okay. This same thing can go there. Under this, you can have stretch, balance, and flexibility as a this tick mark kind of a thing. Very small one. Yeah, it's not like very obvious.
You are saying that this is the main screen. And after this starts, there will be a small section to actually check the other things, right?
Correct. In the down itself, there is a space now, right?
Yeah, because...
And there itself, a small thing can be given like balance, stretch, and flexibility. Tick, tick, tick.
Yeah. I will. Okay. I will pass that with the UI guy. Yeah. And he'll come up with the...
Correct.
Okay.
So now I'll log a physical activity. I'll just search for walking. And then here I can provide the duration. I'll say 30 minutes and the calorie will be calculated and shown here. Then I can submit it. So it is logged now. I think if I will share the screen to show it on the
Sure. I think I need your email ID.
It's lebbybadre@yahoo.in. I'll stop this screen.
Huh? Doji.
Do you guys able to see my screen?
Yeah.
Okay. So here there is a tab called lifestyle. Under this segment, there is a lifestyle activities. here you can see for past 6 days logging of physical activity. Let me log walking outside for 30 minutes and it is 65 calorie and total of 200 calorie. Let me has burned 65 calorie.
Once again, this is coming where? Yeah,
In the user's detail, just like user meal images. Next to that, lifestyle is there, and in that lifestyle activities, I have added the tab called lifestyle activities. In that, physical activity, sleep logging, and water logging is coming.
Okay, fine. That's good actually. In fact, it'll be very useful. So that they can see what activity they've done. But at the client side, they are able to see what they have logged, right?
Yeah. With the date, they can see the what
and all. Can I log that also? In the next phase, we will have to make it more appealing. You know how?
Yeah, understood. We what I have thought is actually we need a sidebar rather than this.
Exactly.
Yeah, these tabs and all will go out.
Correct. And the sidebar and also when the sidebar opens, just show it as a graph or something. Yeah, and the graph, when you click, you get the details. We'll get into that actually. Show me how the user side they see it actually.
1 minute, I will stop share. Labi, will you share that?
So here they will be seeing the progress in the dashboard itself. Exercise, 65 out of 400, 8%.
Okay. So they are seeing it, but here there is no graphical representation, just like the there also the calorie was not graphically represented. It was showing us how much percentage.
For the first phase we are just reflecting the data. Later we can implement the graph.
One
question for him, sir Rabib, can you just go back? So this one, I have a question. The logged exercise, when you look at it, right? If I add 2 or 3, this add physical activity will go down or what?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, that we need to plan, right? How we will
actually. Then I will tell Labib to actually put the add physical activity on the top.
Yeah, that either it should be on the top or can we reorganize it like something which is like a plus or something like that? I don't know.
Yeah, that also I was actually thinking. Just near to that log exercise, we can actually give a plus symbol.
Correct. Yeah.
Not that. Yeah.
So I'll just log one more exercise. And then for 10 minutes. And then when I click on this card on the top, I'll get to see the whole day exercise, running, walking, and the total calorie over here. And then user can.
Good. I said good one.
Which one?
This is good actually. Only thing is that initial page looks
The cardio thing and all, right? That we will
need for that. First the page and the down you can have that.
I will tell you.
Cardio thing in the same page itself, right?
Yes. Under that you have a small
The scrolling thing has to be limited and bottom of that we can actually add that thing.
Okay. I'll just show what is there in my mind as a picture. You can just share. It's very simple. You can do that.
Yeah, understood. And also, I will share the image of that once he actually updated the.
User can edit it. Change the minute. I will change it to 20 now. Then update. It will be updated.
One thing actually, you remember this guy Jason was asking about this. Jason, actually I told him that we will have a demo soon, so I told that Arina was unwell, so he's saying that take your time. So they are also like very nice people. So maybe the next week only we'll have the demo. And meanwhile, I wanted to tell you this thing. Actually, this he was asking about the timing or something, timing of meal, you know, like because of this variation, the different countries, though we have very less number of people, but the people are from different countries, Ghana to Taipei to Casablanca to different countries, no? So he was asking about, is it possible to capture the time or put the time or something of the meal or something, no? Or the exercise or something.
Time means I didn't get you. The local machine time. What you?
Or time zone. So yeah. Messaging them based on time zone.
Okay, that we can actually fetch from the location.
Okay. So keep that in mind. To have a discussion. So,
what I will do is I will anyway that is what we needed. I don't think that that is backend is not doing that.
So why don't you have a meeting around that? Actually, we'll discuss this and see how.
So Vahim, we have spent a lot of time around this time zone thing when we developed it. So it's okay. What I'm thinking is we will have to have a discussion to discuss that.
Yeah, what my thinking is we will only store the time zone at the user's app side. So whatever the time comes, we will actually correct it.
Yeah, okay. Let's discuss that anyway.
Yeah, anyway, we will have a meeting later.
Okay. So I'll delete this. User can also delete the log. So I'll just delete it now. And it is deleted. So that's about physical activity. So I'll go back to dashboard. And then the next one is sleep logging. So sleep logging is available at track sleep and hydration. So you click on this sleep. And then first the user will be asked to set up the tracker, like the usual time. To show the notification, now I'll just give 8:30. And then wake up at 6 a.m. And then their sleep goal will be also shown in the screen, recommended. So just click on done. And then after that, they have to log their sleep. And then they can edit the sleep time. The wake up time, and then this they should click on this yes button to log the sleep. So after logging the sleep, their sleep time and wake up time will be shown here, and then the graph will be seen here below. So they can either see it a weekly or monthly. When I click on monthly, it will be shifted to month.
So you know, here actually is it showing actually like we kept like 7 hours as a actual quad.
Yeah.
So if it is below or more, are we giving a warning or any message or anything? Or
as if no messaging is there, we can always come up with that because we have data.
Yeah, right? Is it like a graph? Okay, how do they? How will they? Like after a week, they want to see like their sleep pattern. How will that happen?
I think, Labi, you need to actually log the yesterday's sleep also.
Then two sleeps you show me actually because this is very important.
Yeah, also demo, in demo, prepare this data and keep, Labib. So at least
one big data.
You need to have that.
Because today also there is a report about melatonin and COVID severity. So we should have this data. They will all come up with this now.
Yeah. Okay. Labib, can you actually log yesterday's just to see how the graph is drawing?
I think for sleep logging, I have only enabled the current date.
Okay. Then you can.
I think we can write a SQL script and keep, right? Are we storing this in Mongo? Fine.
No.
I am actually here. 1 minute. I will actually put that this thing. Then you can actually see. 1 minute.
Yeah. Just have a script which will just insert stuff into Mongo. That's good enough.
Okay. One minute, I will actually put that.
So we should be receiving a notification at 8 o'clock, asking to like reminding them that sleep time is after 30 minutes.
పడతాం సార్ చర్మ
I have added last two dates. Maybe you can you go and actually check again. Yeah, maybe the data will not be this. Yeah, data is actually wrong. Okay.
Clients, ఒక ఇష్యూ సమ్ ఇష్యూ విత్ ద డేటా ఇస్ నాట్ కమింగ్
మేబీ విల్ యు చెక్ దట్ ఐ డోంట్ నో వెదర్ ఇట్ విల్ Yes, login again. I think I have deleted that data. Just log in your thing. Today sleep. Okay, I think some problem with that. Go ahead. I think in the next demo we can actually show that. Hello.
Okay.
Go ahead with the next one.
Yeah.
Basically, this thing to be rectified before the external demo.
Yeah,
so that we have at least 5-6 data and show them that this is how we track. People can track.
Just make a note of that.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll just add the data before that.
Okay. And then do the water logging.
So this is the water logging. We can see a 0 of 12 plus consumed. So when I click on that, I can just log my water. I could use this slider or the plus or minus button over here. So I log 6 glass of water. and then it is locked. I think I'll stop the sharing and
yeah, I will start.
Chat.
Yeah.
1 second. We have received a notification saying it's time to sleep in 30 minutes.
Very visible. So there is a message associated with the switch off your blue light devices. Get the room with. Yeah, I'll give you that.
Yeah, we can add the text.
Yeah, I'll give you that.
Ravi, quick question. These notifications, can we make it more pictorial? Can we actually, rather, these are very plain notifications, right? Can we have them with pictures or slightly larger messages?
Yeah, we can have a drawable, like small image and all.
Correct.
Just right side of that thing, we can actually add. That is Android's default template for the notification for greater than Android 10, I think.
So when the user click on this, they'll be redirected to the sleep logging section.
Yeah, I think I will share the screen to show you the sleep logging and the water logging for that user. See, you can see, right? Hello?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, this is what he have logged. April 28, 2021, 8:30, and wake up at April 29, 6 a.m. Okay. 10.5 hours.
Okay, total hours spent in sleep is 9.5 hours.
You can see the past 6 days sleep with the respective to that date.
Yeah.
And for the water logging also, you can kind
of... Yeah, there are a few things that we need to discuss in sleep, but not in this. Basically, people have uninterrupted sleep, interrupted sleep. They went to bed, but got the sleep after 1 hour.
Yeah, I understand that.
We will do it in the next phase.
Yeah, that I think we need actually device integration.
Correct.
Something so we can get the data from that and we will see whether that is actually...
Yeah. Or not.
This is water logging visualization for the backend.
Yeah.
The number of glass 6 and required glass is 12.
Okay.
Interesting. So these are the new features we have added to the backend, and also we will go with the expert chat. Maybe you can actually chat.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll just message fine.
Yeah, you can share. My sharing will be there.
So I'll send a message.
Are you sharing? Okay. Yes, share.
This is going to be tricky. How do we share both? So is it possible for you to show Fahim this app also? Or can Labib log in? Because then he can keep both side by side. He can keep the app thing here.
Yeah, and, I think Labib is the one can actually present the demo with the backend and also into this thing. Okay. But what happens is we can actually, with the Google Meet, we can actually present two screens.
Oh, is it? With Google Meet, you can do that.
Yeah, one can be whoever actually presenting. That screen will be this thing. Whenever we click on that, the other screen will come very fast. There is no need to actually switch on and switch in.
Yeah, but then the person who is actually seeing it has to switch, right? Here it should be seamless.
Because
I don't think
I have an idea.
Jason and his father will have that kind of this thing, flexibility like us, right? So we should.
Labib has an idea. Let him discuss.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry, I didn't hear that. Yeah.
Yeah, I think we could just open another meet in this tab and then show my screen over there. Google Meet or something.
Another will put it to the
That will be tricky, Labib.
It will be
more complicated. I think you can actually minimize this browser and you can use that this thing, either emulator or you can use this thing, Visor, to show that app things. So people will understand and see the reflections on both sides.
Okay.
Yeah. Now you share the screen first and put all the messages. And I will send you the message back.
Okay. So I think you need to stop the sharing.
Yeah. I think so. Yes, sir.
So there are two types of chat, guide chat and expert chat. So when the user click on this button, those two options will be visible. So I'll just click on this expert chat for now. I've already sent a hi, and then they can send the voice note.
Are you speaking something or?
I don't think so. Just send a picture.
So we are allowing video and audio also.
Yeah, video and audio also.
Yeah, I think we need to also have a strategy around how this will work for paid and unpaid customers.
Because the storage thing, right?
Yes.
So what I was thinking is we will keep the unpaid customers only just 1 week chat or somewhere. We can actually. Or we will provide the video and audio option only for the paid ones.
Yeah. I think we should leave that. But then when they click it, we should actually tell that you are not a paid customer. This feature is available only for paid customers.
Yeah, that we can actually do. Yeah. According to the user program plan,
correct.
We can actually tell that we can actually give a toast.
Yes.
Exactly. You are actually not a paid person. You need to change the plan, not a paid person. This is image, right? You can click on that video. Okay. So I think I will share the screen now.
No, I didn't get you actually this thing.
Which one?
The chat with expert means you are using the chat with expert on the app, right?
Yeah.
And there is an audio and a video chat.
Yeah. Audio or video mean we can actually send the audio and video.
Oh, there wonderful. Is... Yeah, that's good.
We can actually send the audio and video and all images and the
PDF. But is it going to be too much for our cloud if they are sending? Audio is fine, videos.
Yeah, that is what audio will not be. I don't think that audio will take much space. The video, I think it will take time. It will take storage. So what we are actually thinking is we will limit the free customers that you are not actually a paid one. You need to actually change the plan for the actually upload the video.
Exactly. Premium plan only we should give the video upload. Yeah.
So we can actually give the toast in the app itself.
Correct.
Say that. You are not a paid one or something.
Yeah,
sure. So what we have achieved is not we are not discussed on a business side. Mm-hmm. We have achieved all the functionality.
Just telling because it shouldn't be like this thing up.
I was also concerned on that.
No.
Then I was thinking that later we will plan accordingly.
Mm-hmm.
Then, so what I will do is I will share my screen to show how the messages are coming in the back.
Correct.
So you can see, right?
Correct.
So whatever the Labib has sent me, I have received here.
Yeah.
Okay. Video, audio, and all.
Yeah,
and you can also send, you can upload. As of now, there is no option to record. Because AngularJS is not limited. AngularJS is actually a pretty old version. So it is actually having so many problems for the recording, but you can always upload the sounds.
Yeah.
If you have a recording, plus you can just click on this recording and just click on this and it will uploading and it will send to the user.
So you cannot upload directly your see.
Yeah, what I mean, the recording option is not actually seamless in this AngularJS. It is very
no, but for the app they can directly upload.
Yeah, for the app they can actually upload.
For us, we just need only the commenting, or we can record
yeah.
it and upload.
Yeah, we just record and actually put there.
Okay, now this expert chat. Actually, I'm just clarifying. In our system, we have something called guide chat and expert chat.
We have that thing. Okay. Since I am an expert chat, I'm seeing this thing.
Yeah.
In the app also, they can actually chat with the guide. The same functionality will be there also. I think maybe you can actually show the chatbot feature also. So meanwhile, we have developed only for the wait this thing.
Have you checked actually while we are playing, we are able to play their audio here and able to.
Yeah. You can actually see. Are you able to hear my voice? I don't think so.
Nothing we are hearing.
Yeah, because I think in the screen share, I don't think that they will actually capture the audio. I am actually able to hear.
But otherwise, whatever they are, this thing, we can clearly hear the audio, right?
Yeah, you can actually hear the audio. Everything is working. The video and all, everything is working. So when you can click on this thing, it will be seen in the full screen. Mm-hmm. So the condition things and all user can easily send through.
Okay.
Yeah. And one thing, one more thing is that the chatbot. So what we are actually planned is the chatbot is a periodically updating thing, right? So for what we are planning is actually there is a cron job will work in the backend. And weekly, it will send the notification. Based on that notification, a card will pop up. Once from that card, the user will be able to actually update their measurements.
Okay.
So for the demo, we have put the wait, the measurement updating as in the chatbot thing. So okay. Labib will show you that. Before that, I will show you the current weight of the Labib. It is 65 kg, okay? And he is going to update through the chatbot.
Okay.
Hello, Labib. So before that, I will tell you, once the notification comes in a week, this card will pop up, not this card. I told Labib to change the card, the other old one.
Yeah.
Expert commented on the mail, like team was there.
Okay.
So he put this card for the time being. This may, based on that notification, there will be a card will come here. User have to click on this card. Then it will be landed on the chatbot thing.
Okay, this is the chat icon. No, like click on the chat icon. Both the expert and guide chat. Both are
yeah. Yeah, expert chat and guide chat.
Okay, expert is on the top and guide is in the below. Yeah,
yeah, that we can actually rearrange. According to your answers.
Okay, one more thing is actually when we like say we may and we are putting this out in the market and our Android clients are shifting to this, you know, and the iOS clients remains on the older app. And, you know, how will we kind of, okay, they will not be still able to upload the investigation report through this, right? From the back end only you have to do. Yeah.
No, we can do something.
It's not needed. I'm asking because
See, the thing is, we can do it in one way where we can try and see whether two installations of the setup is there. Then the cost will double. That's the only problem because the backend, whatever is the current backend, cannot support the security model because that we have completely changed, right?
Yeah.
Then what is the use of this having this thing in the market? Because I'll have to check how many people are using iOS. You know, like if it is one or two people, we can.
No, I am not saying that. I'm not saying that we cannot use it. I'm saying there will be a cost factor because this is a complete
thing.
Two servers. Yeah, we have to keep two servers. One for iOS, one for this thing. So there will be the server is what costs maximum, right? We are spending almost $100 a month.
Mm-hmm.
on that, that would probably become $200.
Mm-hmm.
Unless, until we make iOS app available with the same configuration, that cost will have to be borne by us.
Okay.
Yeah, let me go ahead. Hello?
Yeah.
Hello? Yeah. So after the notification, there will be a message from, it was a name you have given, right, Eva?
Eva or something, yeah.
Yeah, just we have given that. Eva is our bot. So it's time to update your weight. Do you want to update now?
But I think the photograph should be of a girl.
Yeah. Eva. Not Lavi.
That is
initially what... I used to think this picture is Labib's photo. You
know, it's not Labib. I thought it was Labib. No.
In the initial demo and all, I used to think this is Labib's photo. Then only I understood it's a common thing.
Okay. I thought it was Labib's photo.
Yeah, because the user profile thing is coming in the next module.
Uh-huh.
That only we can actually change the pictures and all.
Okay.
That meanwhile, we are actually giving the default picture.
Okay.
Yeah. Just give the answer.
So the chatbot is starting with telling your weight. That's the first thing it is asking. Or it's not asking for what? Actually, what are you looking for?
Always they can actually chat, the chit chat and all. How are you actually doing all? This is basically the intent based. Whenever the notification comes, this will be this thing. Because in a weekly span, we are actually sending a notification. It's time to update your weight.
Correct.
At that time, because I want to show you how this actually, if Labib actually saying, how are you, the chatbot will reply.
No, it's a, the question has to be reframed. Have you updated weight on your app?
Yeah.
On your this thing? If it is yes, what is the weight? Are you happy or something like that?
But, yeah, that we can actually do. We can actually always give more messages.
Correct.
What we have achieved is the functionality base. Not on the user aspect. What we have done is because user just inputted the 85 kg through in message.
Yeah.
We have already updated the system.
Correct.
So I will share the screen to show you. It is updated here.
And also show me a new user coming, how the chat will happen.
Yeah, that we need to actually define what and all we need to actually give the users.
Okay, it's not done.
It's not that in the sense we are actually capturing all the measurements.
As the user comes initially, that is something we need to define for the next 2 days and put it, because new user registers, they should be asking, you know, this Eva should be asking the relevant questions. Are you looking for any of IOH services? You know, are you having any weight issues or health condition? Sure,
that is what I understood. But we need that detailed thing. In the back end, we have to give that thing, how the users have to be navigated.
Yeah.
Are you looking for a professional coach or something?
I'll have to give you that.
So you have to give all the cases.
Yeah.
Then you can actually define in the chat. And whenever we have to actually pop up the chat.
Yeah.
So when on the first day or a very first login, we are actually popping the Eva with some other messages. Welcome to Investron Health. Do you want any assistance for uploading your meal? Just like that.
Mm-hmm.
That we need to actually define.
Correct. How long it will take if I define and give you tomorrow?
Yeah, I think 2 to 3 days, I think.
Right? Before the demo, let's have that actually, because very important, because this anyway, regular chat is taken care of.
Yeah, okay. So
what we need is the initial chat and navigating people to...
We can actually give the questions and the expected answers.
Exactly.
We can actually implement that also.
Yeah, we'll do that. I'll give you, because there is a flow for that.
Yeah. So what I will show you is the last thing. I will show you the backend. It is updated. The weight, whatever the A is inputted, it has been updated.
Automatic update happens?
Yeah, it will update.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, there is nothing user need to do. Just input the 85 kg in the chat. Nothing else user need to do.
Yeah, that's why bots are so popular, right?
Yeah, this is good actually. This is something which will definitely. But initial part, I think Suresh and me can have a discussion tomorrow. Yeah. And
if you guys can actually give that questionnaires and the possible answers also,
so that they use all the features in the app and get the thing ready.
You know? And also you need to, so for the demo, we can only see the after the sign in intent, right?
Yeah.
Just be after the sign in, we can actually see, because for a real life say, scenario, the bot will asking first day, then 3 days after, why are you not logging the meal, just like that.
Correct.
So see, it is 85 kg.
Yeah, correct.
Whatever, it is updated.
Perfect.
So we are not covered height in this match. All the other measurements we will ask.
Yeah.
I don't know whether height is a variable or
not. Height is not variable. Height is not.
Yeah. So all the other measurements we can actually capture through bot.
Correct.
Yeah, we will have a update history and all.
Yeah. Also, the chatbot will take care of a reminder for meal update. Have you uploaded your meals today?
Chatbot, we can actually inject that to the chatbot, because anyway we are actually sending the notifications. So chatbot will we will actually let the chatbot know that this intent has to be started.
Okay.
After that, so the chatbot will pop up with a question: have you uploaded your meal? The if they are saying no, so are you going to upload it now? Just like that, we can give.
Correct.
So what actually is a chatbot is a medium. All we have to do is we have to define all the scenarios before that.
You know, what I was thinking is actually, you know, we'll have to have just like WhatsApp, having one medium, WhatsApp group, where the client is interacting everything with us. If chatbot is taking care of the whole thing, you know, then like notification at one place, then yeah, notification is still okay because it comes as an image and these things and all. But otherwise, if it goes to chatbot, it would be good. You know, a reminder to upload your meals, a reminder to update your weight, like that. You know, these kind of information go through chatbot, it would be good, I think.
Yeah. So what the is there? It is actually a scenario based, because whether we need actually any input from the user based on the notification.
Correct.
Whether it can be captured through chatbot, we will actually do that.
Yeah.
Otherwise, we can't do. We will only navigate to whatever the chatbot will navigate the user to meal uploading screen.
Correct.
Based on that.
Okay.
So just like that, I will tell you the example. So chatbot will ask the users on 8 o'clock whether you are not logged any meal.
Yeah.
Do you want to actually update the meal? So user say yes. So we will tell you. Are you want to upload the meal now?
Wow.
The user will yes. Then we will give a small card item. The user can click and it will go to that upload meal things.
Okay. Yeah, that's something like that, you know, navigating people to keep uploading their meals. That's very important, you know, like whatever this thing is, maximum result happens with people who keep uploading their regular meal plate.
Yeah. So what we will do is we can actually achieve that. With that things, and user will go to that internet. After finishing that, where the bot will itself says, "Oh yeah, we have finished your uploading of meals. Thank you."
Correct.
Yeah, that we can achieve, but it will take time.
Yeah, no problem. Let's focus only on the initial interaction. This demo. Let it be. We can keep on adding, keep on improving the chatbot. Right.
Yes. Yeah, chatbot can be do the n scenarios, number of scenarios. That is not a problem, but we have to define the scenarios. That's all. Yeah, I think we have completed everything we have listed out.
Yeah, I think it has come out well. We'll have to keep on evolving.
Yeah.
Before the demo, whatever we have discussed, I'll put this recording on the YouTube so that Labib can check. Actually, one is regarding the sleep thing, the data was not working. Another one was regarding the physical activity, where the cardio, those demarcations are not needed. only a checkbox can be given down as a not as a prominent one. It is there, but it's not very prominent kind.
Yeah.
And I'll try and see if I can share this thing. And then chatbot, you know, initial onboarding process has to be through chatbot. You know, that me and Suresh will have a discussion tomorrow or the weekend and then provide a list of things, questions and answers, and how to navigate people into completing the
app. I think for the next meeting, rather than recording, you can actually stream the meeting to YouTube. So after this, it will automatically save to YouTube. Right?
Perfect. We'll do that actually. You have my ID and password. You can directly do that also.
Yeah,
we can do that. Or you just remind me, we can do it.
Yeah.
Okay. Anything else? I think it's coming out well. It's shaping up well. Only thing is, we are all getting tired with a lot of cases happening. One or the other getting sick, hospitalization. You know, it's very bad.
So, BB is also the most number of cases. BB has come from Calicut, right?
Labib?
Yeah, the BB is actually coming from Calicut.
I know, yeah.
Yeah, Calicut is having most number of cases. I don't know when the lockdown and all.
Yeah, we have lockdown here. Bangalore is in lockdown, no?
Yeah.
It's bad actually. But anyway, all of you stay safe. Take some vitamin supplement. Do not get exposed. Some kind of zinc with LMC or vitamin D. Take it regularly for at least 1 or 2 weeks so that everybody is safe and sound. Okay then.
Yeah.
Thank you all. Thanks.
Yeah, bye.
Yeah, thanks, guys. It's gone.